and to give us the message from the Department of Health of our regional director and the chairperson of the Nutrition Committee, we have Ms. Ulasini Pangan to read the message on behalf of the regional director.
Happy 46th Nutrition Month celebration. This year's celebration is indeed very different and distinct from our previous celebration, as we are caught in a very abnormal time, faced with a great challenge of fighting the effects and consequences of this global pandemic. This public health emergency has drastically affected the lives of every family. This significantly limits our families to access health goods and services, thus putting our people, especially our infants and young children, more at risk of malnutrition. Nonetheless, it is still of utmost importance that amidst the pandemic, we need to sustain our efforts on promoting the significant role of proper nutrition on child's health and development. This year's theme, Batang Pinoy Sana Tol, Iwas Stunting Sama All, focus on catalyzing actions to address child stunting. Stunting, Tagalog term, pagkabansot, especially in the first 1,000 days of life of the child, is irreversible. It has harmful consequences for the individual and society, ranging from low educational performance, increased risk of non-communicable disease later in life, and loss of productivity. Our region is still facing the war on malnutrition. Of course, with our continued fight, we are improving in our efforts to reduce the number of stunted children in the region. Our data shows a prevalence rate of stunting among under 5 children of 17.6%, signifying achievement in our PIPAN goal of 21.4%. As we celebrate the 46th Nutrition Month celebration, I continue to urge our mothers and frontline health and nutrition workers to continue fighting this battle, especially in this time of crisis. For our mothers and family members, let us be aware that stunting is an illness and leads to poor health, poor school performance, and low productivity. Bring your 0 to 23 months old child to health center every month to monitor weight and height. Breastfeed your baby in the first 6 months, then starting at 6 months, give additional food while continuing breastfeeding. For local government, stunting is a complex problem which requires multi-sectoral solutions to ensure family food security. Services in the first 1,000 days per RA 11148. LGUs must prioritize stunting interventions, include nutrition in annual investment plans. Under the new normal, may I reiterate that good nutrition is key to build immunity, protect against illness and infection, and support recovery. Efforts to preserve and promote proper nutrition, including breastfeeding and appropriate complementary feeding practices among children 0 to 23 months, must be part of the COVID-19 prevention strategies to build resilience of individuals and communities. Let us ensure that in this time of crisis, nutrition and related interventions, especially in the first 1,000 days, are continued and delivered in a safe and sustained manner for our children to achieve full potential. More importantly, let us continue to practice the health protocols mandated for us to prevent the spread of infection. Let us always wear our face mask, observe physical distancing, and practice frequent hand washing. Together, we heal as one.
Ms. Ula, that is the message of our regional director of the Department of Health, at the same time, the Regional Nutrition Committee Chairperson, Dr. Minerva P. Mulon. So with that, we would like to introduce now our 46th Nutrition Month celebration with the message coming from the Regional Nutrition Program Coordinator of the National Nutrition Council Region 8, Dr. Catalino P. Dotolio Jr.
Maupay nga aga, bisan guti la kita, no? So this is the normal, no, of today, no, as far as activities, no, in the government and the other sectors, no. So at the outset, no, I would like to greet and thank Tacloban City Mayor Alfred Romualdez, no, for in close coordination with the Tacloban City Nutrition Office and Tomeco, no, for giving us the opportunity, no, to conduct a one of a kind. If it is, this is called big bang or a small bang because of the pandemic or because of the COVID threat, but in spite of that, we are able to get a go signal from these very people, no, to conduct this they call this one a motorcade, no, although people from the central office oppose these activities I've suggested, but in the long run I told central office people that we will still get the nod of the Tacloban City Mayor plus Tomeco if they will allow us. And we will also, in the promise that we will also, in our meeting, no, in the Regional Nutrition Cluster meeting, that we will observe health protocols, no, social distancing, wearing a mask, similar others, such that those that are invited in the during that meeting is that we will allow government vehicle to be used, at least 2 to 3 passengers, including driver, to go with the motorcade, and without getting out of their cars. And after the route, no, of the motorcade, they will go to the respective offices or to the respective work from home, no, nga mga modes, no. Anyway, thank you. Please tell the good mayor of our gratitude of granting this opportunity, no, to conduct the launching here in Tacloban City. And then of course I would like to take this opportunity to thank, no, even a short notice and of probably on a self quarantine Director Mulon for giving us his her 2020 nutrition message. Of course I would like also to thank, no, the panelists here presence, of course the Department of Agriculture being the vice chair person of the Regional Nutrition Committee. We have represented here by Francis Rosaroso, our very good friend. Of course we have from the DSWD Rachel Balasik, no, and then we also have from the City Nutrition Office Tacloban City, Maluta Bao. And of course, from the province of Leyte, Pinao, Tesli Guzman. Of course, our friends from the Harmonized Initiative of Media in the Spread of Good Nutrition, or Himsug Ocho. Of course, I was so very happy, no, to although I cannot see very clearly, no, sorry for my defective eyesight, Director Olive Chu of the Philippine Information Agency. Please wave, ma'am. The always beauteous Olive Chu, no, of course. With her actually is Sol, okay, so. And then, and the rest of the other participants, no, good morning and happy Nutrition Month celebration! Morning. Okay, no, so, despite pandemic, we should be very aggressive, no? So, this year's, no, Nutrition Month is actually the 46th year of its observance and is focused on the team Batang Pinoy, Sana Tol, Iwas Stunting, Sama All, no, which actually expresses the aspiration of Filipino families to have children who are able to achieve their fullest potential. And this can be achieved when we all work together. And thank you for coming over with this regional launching. Though, because of the pandemic, there is a sub-message, if you will look at your collaterals given to you and even the t-shirts, no? We have a sub-message of Iwas All Din sa COVID-19, no? So, this is added given the pandemic and the community quarantine, which is still in effect in most, no, of local government unit, no? And it becomes more imperative to ensure nutrition among Filipinos to improve their resilience against disease and minimize the long-term effect of malnutrition, particularly stunting or putot, no? So putot, no? So our campaign aims to catalyze action, no, para pag-increasing awareness on the impact of stunting or ang pagkaputotan bata, no? Kay we are actually focusing on children rather than of adults, no? And the proven evidence-based solution, no, among families and communities leading in change in behaviors to prevent stunting, no? Para pagpreventarin kaputotin bata, no? And then para pag-auhag ha, national and local, no, including ang aton mga komunidad on mga horo. Ano yan? How do we term that in Waray? Horo humangraw. Oh, on stunting and understand its causes, no, and the multi-sectoral solutions for increased investment and interventions. No, it's not only awareness, but most especially is on commitment and nutrition investment of our local chief executive or local government units, no, and pag-generate in concrete commitment among various stakeholders to scale up nutrition action. So as we all know, July is designated as a nutrition month, but our action is geared, no, on the objective of sustaining the campaign even beyond July 31, no. So we move ato kini ipadayo, no, even July 31, no. So let me share to you, no, some beliefs and attitudes, no, on the social and behavior communication change communication plan on infant and young child feeding, no. There are several obstacles, no, in infant and young child feeding, no. Kakulang hin knowledge, no, kakulang hin kaibaro ang aton mga target audience, particularly ang aton mga nanay, mga caregivers, diri ra maaram, no, on what is stunting, no. Kay nabilib kita nga later on, no, when we do the formal open forum, nabilib kita nga ang kapututan tao, ang kahabubo is just normal kay mga Pinoy good kita, no. So well, probably yes, but given the opportune in environmental, good environmental factors, then optimal growth and development among our children, particularly in the first 1,000 days, can be reached. No, maprebentaran ini nato kung maaram la ang aton mga nanay, kamo nga mga nanay, kita nga mga caretaker or kita nga mga stakeholders on stunting and its indicators, no? So, less concern. Ikaduha nga behavioral obstacles na to is an aton less concern. So, stunting and kahalipot na to or kahabubo, wara, no, did not appear to be a concern for parents or caregiver. Natural man lang ito, no? As I've said a little earlier, no? Then, mga current beliefs, no? Mga pagkayana, no, na parents and or caregivers have long held beliefs and cognitive biases on childcare, no. We know that, no. Labi na aton mga nutrition workers, mga bata pa masiring ito hira nga iday han pagpanganak ko adto kapahaduyan tim nanay. So ayak-yak ni kay mas maaro-aram apa mga things like those, no, nga dapat na to i-change. So these are actually some of the behavioral obstacles, no, as we go along in our celebration and in preventing stunting, not only in Eastern Visayas, but also in the entire country and in the global scene. Know that we hope with these gatherings of gathering of ours and the future gatherings that we will be conducted mga humingraw nga kunta masilsilhan alimpatakan or alintarakan ang aton mga caregivers, mga nanay, and even our local chief executive, no, our stakeholders nga stunting is indeed a problem in this part of the region, in this part of the country, and globally. So I hope with our celebration, no, so let us all help in our plight, no, to prevent stunting, especially among the Eastern Visayas children, and of course to your own children. Maayo nga pag-celebrar nato hini nga Nutrition Month celebration. Damo nga salamat.
Thank you so much, Doc Cathy, for that for the overview of the National Nutrition Month celebration. Again, ano po ang ating tema for this year? Batang Pinoy, sana tol, iwas stunting sa maol, iwas all din sa COVID-19. Okay, and we will now moving on to our next part of our activity and to introduce our panelist or our guest for our open forum and the proper of the press conference. May we have the director of the Philippine Information Agency, Director Erlinda Olive Chu, to moderate and to run the forum.
Ang hirap nang nakamask kasi hindi natin nakikita kung nag-i-smile yung kausap natin o hindi. Naka-smile na po ako yung lagay na to. Pero yung mata ko po talaga parang hindi yata nag-i-smile. Okay. So, first of all, thank you for inviting PIA to this very important gathering. Alam po ninyo, Direk, yung ating paborito po namin dati, yung NNC. In fact, when we organized our HIMSOG 8, kami po yun, yung tumulong, okay, during the time of our good friend, Karina. Okay. So, I am glad na buhay pa po sila. In fact po, they may not be here, pero nakita ko doon, naka-Facebook Live po tayo sa PIA. Ang Region 8 Yana. Nakita ko nag-share si Ray Gaspay from Catbalogan. Hindi ko pa tinignan kung sino-sino yung ibang members natin na nag-share. Pero I'm sure that, kasi kaninang umaga, yung iba nagtatanong ano yung activity today. And so sabi ni, sinabihan naman sila ni Sol, but ay parang kulang na siguro ng time na pumunta sila dito. Plus the fact na right now, ay meron din ongoing na DOH press conference, so virtual na presser sila, director. Okay. Anyway, yung pong nanotice po natin, yung basta Nutrition Month, ano, very catchy palagi yung ating tema. Ano? So ngayon na naman, yung tema natin ay Batang Pinoy, sana tol. Mga bagets to sila, Direk. Sila ano? Oo. Iwas stunting, sama all. Iwas din sa COVID-19. Okay. So, bago tayo magsimulang magtanong, I would like to introduce our, of course, yung mga ating mga resource person ay pinangungunahan ni Dr. Cathy. Okay. ang ating Regional Nutrition Program Coordinator for Eastern Visayas. Kasama din natin si Mr. Francis Rosaroso, kaibigan din natin from the Department of Agriculture. Francis. Kasama natin from DSWD, Maria Rachel Balase. Ba istanted day? Okay, hindi naman daw. Hindi. Okay. Tapos, kasama din natin ang ating Leyte Provincial Action Officer, Stella De Guzman. Stella Therese De Guzman. Okay. Yung ating Tacloban City Nutrition Action Officer na si Maria Lumen Tabao. Lumen yung nandito. Sabi ko, ba't ganun? Okay, so umpisahan po natin yung tanong. Sino yung unang magtatanong? Palagay ko ako muna yung magtatanong. Ano? Director, pwede ba ako magtanong muna? Okay. Ano po yung stunting? At saka ano po yung cause ng stunting? Kasi parang yan yata yung pinaka-root na ano ng ating tema ngayong araw na to.
Hello, good morning once again, no? So, yung stunting actually kung ato ng Bisaya on magbawta Bisaya, no? So, putot kung Bisaya sa amo putot, ambot din sa inyo sa baray,
putot gihapon.
Or habubo or halipot. Okay, so that's actually the definition of stunting in Bisaya, no? So, but technically, stunting is actually ang bata, particularly below 2 years old, is short by his or her height, no? Based upon his age also, no? So, ginsisiring, very technical, no? Z standard deviation ang tawag dito statistically, no, lower an iya height than the normal, no, or kung severe 3, no, standard deviation, no, to the left, no. So amo ito, so basically habubo an iya height han iya edad. Okay, so there are basically, to the second question of the good and beautiful director of PIA, the second is that there are drivers in stunting, no? Based on detailed analysis and are affected by factors before birth and secondly, factors after birth. No? So, stunting is likely to happen with poor, yung number one to, yung pre-birth, no? Poor maternal nutrition and nutrition, no? So, probably kulang maupay nga nutrition na nato nanay, haniya pagbuburod, which would likely result to low birth weight, no? Habubo ang timbang, han bata, dida haniya pag-anak. No? So, and then may iba nga ni nga ginkikita pa nga ni at ha womb small ang iya gestational age, no? Guti, no? No? So, ang risgo ini nga ang risgo pagod hinin is that damo ini nga naapektuhan kun mga bata pa nagbuburod or adolescent pregnancy, which is increasing not only in the country but in Eastern Visayas, no, admittedly, no. So PAPCOM could attest to that we have a very high incidence of teenage pregnancy, no. So factors after birth, ginsiring ko nga second factors include amo na ini anakon ginsisiring kanina nga mga obstacle behavior or behavior obstacles, no. Poor dietary diversity of children that is driven by both feeding practices and high prices of nutrition foods. Mahal, no? Although we can plant in our backyard, pero we really have to go into that, no? Maihang proseso, but is very effective, no? So, Amoy no, ang iya pagkaon dida na ang iya afterbirth, particularly 0 to the first, second year of life of that particular child. No? So, amo ito ang duduha nga pakiaan, ikaduha nga pakiaan ni Director Olive as anot mga kausay ni, no? Before birth or pregnancy and after birth.
So dapat pala nagbuburod pala ang nanay kailanglan maupay ang iya mga gingkakaon ano kay para ang iya gimbuburod dire maapektuhan. Okay? So question from Sol Alarcon.
Another stunted. Damang pakiana didi, ma'am, sir. Tikang iba-iba nga mga media. Ako irentuin na nalang magbasa. What are the COVID-19 health check-up protocols for children getting sick? Is there a mandatory COVID testing to both mother and child? From Sir Ray Gaspay.
Actually, I think no, tomorrow kasi we have a webinar on stunting and COVID-19, no? But suffice it to say, the children nga mong ginyayakan belongs to the high risk vulnerable population, no? So among ani nga dapat kunta diri ni ragin i-expose nato hin mga adult and should be kept inside the home kaya hindi sila ma-expose in the transmission of the virus. But nonetheless, we have a very low both incidence and prevalence of what do you call this one, COVID-19 among the very young children. So probably because of the effect, no, of the minimum standard imposed to the local government unit up to the barangay level nga diri gud ini daging papagawas kay makuyaw hinduro kun matapunan hira hin COVID-19 ang virus, no. So basically the same lagi hapon Sol an ila what they call this one atong standard, no. So if they I hope the DOH is listening, no, kung kasi may ginyayakan nga nan asymptomatic, may da mild signs and symptoms, may da severe signs and symptoms, no. So those having mild and severe signs and symptoms probably will be taken into our referral hospitals, no, parang ma-address, no, ang ila mga needs. But otherwise, kun ada ra kun wara hira symptoms, probably they will just be placed in a community quarantine. Okay? So suffice it to say, waray pagod kita treatment, no. Ay kamo pag tuod dito nga mga ada Facebook, as of today waray pagod kita treatment for COVID-19. All are supportive therapy, no. Kung may fever, gintataganin paracetamol, no. Kung may ubo, gintitreat ang ubo, no. So gaditon, no. So hopefully waray mga bata nato nga magkagagrabe, no. Although probably based on the statistics, may da na good even kita death nga I think 4-year-old, pero dili good damo nga dili good ya parihahan death among adults nga duro damo ay, no. So probably I would request, no, statistically speaking, for the province of Leyte and the city of Tacloban, kung may dahil ang mga kaso, hin mga bata, based on the question of Ms. Sol.
Ray is watching and listening. Naka-online niya. So, Ray, I hope na na-answer yung question mo. Kung may ada ka follow-up question, mag-sering ka otro. Okay. Yung isang tanong dito is, how can programs projects of NNC be implemented in the new normal?
May I just inform the body that the National Nutrition Council do not have a very specific programs on this, because as an agency, we are the highest policy-making body in terms of nutrition, such that there is what we call the Regional Nutrition Committee, which is a multi-sectoral committee, no? Having members of each of the different member agencies that has nutrition-related programs, projects, and activities, and the local government units also, no? So like, we have for food security, we have Department of Agriculture. For supplementary feeding program, we have the DSWD, no? So those are actually our tangible programs and projects lodged in the different member agency of the Regional Nutrition Committee and even at the national level, no? So what I could get a very specific, although we lay down the policies, no, policy environment that will ultimately address food insecurity and ultimately child stunting and wasting among our vulnerable population. Okay, so Francis and the other panelists may add up to my answers.
Okay, so siguro, Doc, hingan na lang natin sila ng comment. Mensahe ano, tungkol sa ginagawa nila about the theme. Diba? So all of the resource persons will have their chance ano to say something about the theme. Francis?
Okay, good morning, everyone. I'm glad I was invited, even in just a short notice. I miss this group, actually. I've been part of this long time ago.
Long time.
Hindi pa naman. Anyway, as to the question kung ano yung masasabi namin about sa team natin ngayon for the 46th Nutrition Month, Batang Pinoy, sana tol, iwas stunting sa maol. Iwas all din sa COVID-19. So practically, the Department of Agriculture has a vital role in realizing our aspiration, no? For every infant, every child na batang Pinoy na maging matangkad, no? Not only matangkad, but also she or he should be yung maganda yung pangangatawan at saka healthy, in other words. So ang basically ang role namin sa Department of Agriculture, lalo na ngayong COVID-19, because we are transitioning into new normal, we will go on with our promotion of the different programs, yung plant program. Pag sinabi natin plant program, it doesn't mean only that we will focus on the main staple, which is rice. We will also include other commodities, and that includes yung mga high value crops, yung mga nutritious, highly nutritious vegetables, yung sa fisheries, sa livestock, and all other commodities that may help a person grow, glow, and go. So yun po, marami pong mga programa ang DA na at the moment we are trying to continue despite the COVID pandemic, no? And we are very happy na kahit despite the crisis, people has realized, that agriculture basically is the most important, sabihin natin, economic activity. Because without food, we will not exist. Don't tell me that we do not eat every day. So we have all the reason to be thankful to our farmers. That's why farmers are the frontliners. So we try to mobilize people so that plant program of the government will not be hampered. Thank you.
The department has a salient role in terms of this theme, Batang Pinoy, Sana Tall, I Was Standing Small, Sana All. It was all then sa COVID-19. So we are already on the 10th cycle for the supplementary feeding program, which in fact, actually, we had a total amount of 80 million, which is intended for all LGUs who were going to qualify for the said program. So far for this CY 2020, we targeted 40 LGUs of all the 6 provinces, in which from Leyte, we have 9 LGUs covering Tacloban City, Babatngon, Ulita, Carigara, Matag-ob, Kananga, San Miguel, Tabuntabon, Hilongos, and Abuyog. And from Southern Leyte, we also have 9 from Hinunangan, Hinundayan, Liluan, Libagon, San Ricardo, Silago, Tomas Opos, San Juan, Maasin. And from Biliran Province, we have 2, Biliran, Caibiran. From Samar, we have 5, Santa Margarita, Yabong, Mutyong, Gandara, Villarreal. And from East Samar, we have 8. Tuwit, Balanghiga, Arteche, Canavid, Maydulong, Salcedo, Hipapad, Borongan City. And from Northern Samar, we have also 8, which includes the following municipalities: Kapol, Katarman, San Isidro, San Jose, Victoria, Gamay, Bubon, Labisares, which the target beneficiaries of these are the children aging 2 to 4 years old, which actually they are undernourished children, targeting all 44,492. So yung ano po namin scheme is just like last year that we have to undergo the regional procurement process. So lahat po yung procurement is from region. Then the moment that we have one supplier or from the 6 provinces, so yung ginagawa po ng regional office is dinideliver po lahat yung mga items sa targeted na LGUs, and from the LGU, they have their strategies, and actually they have their augmentation para po sa feeding natin sa programa. So far naman, from 2011, which sa year na po nag-start, and up to present, malaki po yung natulong ng departamento para sa mga bata po na nangangailangan po ng na maangat po yung health nutrition natin.
Thank you. Yes, good morning. Good morning, everyone. Okay. In response to the long-time problem of the country, yung stunting natin, the province of Leyte entered into a memorandum of agreement with NNC through the ECCD First 1,000 Days Program. Ito po yung programa talaga na sasagot talaga sa problema natin on stunting. So the program was implemented 2018, nag-start sa province, and it yung objective po, yung goal natin dito was yung projects na in-implement is food security, through the coordination of the Department of Agriculture. So, ang ginawa ng NNC, they downloaded money to the LGUs. By the way, we have 4 priority municipalities in the province of Leyte, which is Hilongos, Mahaplag, Abuyog, and Baybay City. I mean, isa pala yung city, Baybay. So, they NNC downloaded money to the municipality, to the LGU, for farm inputs, nutrition education for our target beneficiaries. Ito yung mga 6 to 23 children na nanbilong sa household na identified as target beneficiaries. And binigyan sila ng nutritional education, binigyan sila ng farm inputs, and procurement of our anthropometric tools, meaning yung weighing scales natin and yung mga height boards and steel rules natin to monitor these beneficiaries kung nag-i-improve nga ang kanilang nutritional status. So, ang role naman po ng Provincial Nutrition Committee of Leyte was more on monitoring and evaluation in the implementation of the program. In fact, nag-create kami ng FB page. Please check our FB page, Provincial Nutrition Office of Leyte. We have been updating the page ever since. And then, we had regular monitoring and evaluation, of course, together with our partners. Aside from NNC, may partner tayo from NISWD, Agriculture, sino pa ba ito? Planning Office, and DepEd. So, all year round po, nag-monitoring kami. Medyo na-stop lang because of the pandemic. But, we have continually been monitoring through social media na muna ngayon. So, yun po.
With regards to the city government of Tacloban, in terms of the monitoring of stunting and COVID-related concerns, we are lucky because we have partner offices like the City Health Office, the Department of Agriculture, the City Agriculture's Office, and the City Social Welfare. With the City Social Welfare, we have coordinated with them regarding the ongoing feeding program. And with the City Agriculture, we also have ongoing communal and backyard gardens. We are very lucky that the Department of Agriculture also is just a stone's throw away from the city hall. So our barangays, pag nauubusan ang seeds and city agri, nalipot lahiranga didiha DA to get. Adaman laha guard, it's very accessible. Adalaha guard house, they can readily ask for the seeds. As you will know, damo na an aspiring agriculturist sa city of Tacloban, because they saw the benefit of vegetable gardening na not only na earn hira, but they also are able to have food ready nga right at their backyard. And with the city health office also, especially sa COVID response, we have been closely partnering with them in terms of monitoring. Our barangay nutrition scholars are also frontliners because they are part of the Barangay Health Emergency Response Team, or the BHERT. And just recently, the offices of the city government, all the departments have already been mobilized to also assist in the processing of registrants for the Balik Tacloban, the locally stranded individuals, and the OFW. So we are also doing home visits. If these returning Tacloban residents are for home quarantine or facility quarantine. So this is all a linkage between all offices of the city government in terms of monitoring of the health of the children and our COVID response. Thank you.
No, as an agency, no, tasks, We have actually the Philippine Plan of Action for Nutrition 2017-2022, no, which actually commensurate with the sitting president and is the blueprint or framework for nutrition implementation in the entire country, no? As a, kasi nga sabi, the PIPAN should have a new, no, branding, no? That's why the branding with the PIPAN 2017-2022 is actually three-pronged. Nutrition-specific intervention, and these nutrition-specific interventions are actually, or answers, no, the immediate causes of malnutrition, gutom. So that's why we have Agriculture Department, we have DSWD, we have DOH giving out, what do you call this one, vitamins to and iron to our pregnant. These are actually direct, no, foods, no, or food that will be given to the vulnerable population, and that is nutrition specific. We have actually nutrition sensitive, no? The nutrition sensitive programs addresses the underlying causes of malnutrition, no? It is somehow, kasi sasabihin nyo, paano si DPWH makakatulong sa prevention ng stunting, eh, infrastructure sila. But we tweak the programs of the DPWH such that it will produce nutrition outcomes. Example, in identifying the workers, no, of the DPWH, they will ask the mayor or the barangay captain in the project site to identify mothers, parents, or household with malnourished children, no, so that they will be the priority being employed in such an infrastructure program. Thereby, after they are being paid, meron na silang pera, so meron na silang ibibili ng pagkain, and in turn, giving out food security in the family, which would ultimately help in producing nutritional outcomes indirectly through the infrastructure project. And the last of the PIPAN program is what we call nutrition-specific, nutrition-sensitive, and enabling mechanism. No, so enabling mechanism, form part of it is policies, plans, and even LGU mobilization efforts. No, we have to mobilize, and even these activities of ours. No, we are engaged. No, para maaghat nato ang mga local chief executive to invest more on nutrition so that our vulnerable population will be safeguarded against the ill effects of malnutrition, particularly stunting and wasting. No? So actually, yun ang sagot ko sa una mo, how does the NNC iron out things before we go into the specific agency, member agency task to implement nutrition-related programs, projects, and activities in their respective agencies. So we have the guide, and the guide is the Philippine Plan of Action for Nutrition 2017-2022. So nasa mid-year na tayo, 2020 na tayo towards the end, and hopefully we would help, no, in producing nutritional outcomes, because we only have four basic objectives that we would want to achieve, no? So child stunting for below 5 years old, child wasting for children below 5 years old, and then micronutrient obesity, which is now a trend na in our country. So those are the four basic objectives that we would want to achieve in implementing the three-pronged programs of nutrition-sensitive, nutrition-specific, enabling programs of the Philippine Plan of Action for Nutrition for 2017-2022. I hope that clarifies everything before we cascade it to the specific agency task not to implement nutrition-related plans, programs, projects, and activities. Thank you.
Ito yung sunod na question. ano daw ng mga measures ang ginawa ng city o kaya provinces ano to protect the barangay nutrition scholars during this time of pandemic? As Malu mentioned a while ago, kasama sila sa BHRTS, yung ating barangay nutrition scholar. So, Apapan, ano yung ginagawa natin para maprotektahan natin sila?
Namin to, di ba, Malu? Because they do all the legwork. And yet, volunteer ang nature ng appointment nila. So, dependent ang pamasahin nila sa barangay. So, mga superhero to sila, actually, even before the pandemic. Because they do the actual work in the barangay, implementing, monitoring, and evaluation the nutrition program. So, anong protection? On my part, puro ano na lang muna tayo. What is this? Reminders to, of course, follow the health protocol. So, sa province of Leyte, kahit maliit o konti lang, nag-procure tayo ng mga face masks and other hygiene items to be provided to them. But then again, sa more than 1,400 na BNS po ng province of Leyte, medyo hindi siya sapat. So we are relying also, and I hope, sa barangay nutrition committees natin na sila din ay binibigyan nila ng enough safety precaution measures para naman talaga matulungan nila, mabuligan hira-hira ano health and health status nila. And sa province of Leyte, yes, nagdu-duty sila sa BHRT. And even during may mga checkpoints, nandun sila, nagdu-duty din. And they are also one of the members in the contact tracing team of the barangay. So from even before the pandemic until now, talagang ang mga BNS namin ay palaging may ginagawa. Thank you.
Same with the province kasi it's a general ano naman na duty, BHRT, contact tracing, monitoring. With regards to the protection, hindi naman natin talaga sila, although they are city paid, some are city paid, some are barangay paid, but hindi lahat sila nakakover ng benefits because, yun nga, lack of funds. But we are lucky that there are some barangays who gave yung mga extra during the times that they were on duty. So the city assisted in terms of lahat kasi ng checkpoints were given food. So city ang nagpapakain sa kanila, and yung city health, while the stocks were still there, gave out vitamins and face masks. Actually, not only the BNS, all more or less the vulnerable sectors were given, each household were given like 5 face masks kasi yun ang ibang reason. They couldn't buy, so nagbigay din ang city. So kasama na din yun ang mga barangay nutrition scholars. And of course, the city has an ongoing program. Actually, it's an ordinance that once a BNS, BSPO, or BHW gets sick, meron silang financial assistance coming from the city. So buti na lang, hindi yun nagamit. Wala namang nagkasakit na mga frontline workers natin. So yun, whatever assistance na nabibigay ng city, especially nung time of the COVID-19 na lahat, we were all on quarantine, hindi na kami masyadong nag-stricto in terms of report. Even walang report, binigyan sila ng kanilang mga, they were given their honorariums, o maski walang report, to help augment na, para may mabili. Yun lang.
Okay, you have an answer.
Kasi binanggit ni Director Chu, no, yung some of our mag-comment na lang kayo. Most of our BNS are members of the Barangay Health Emergency Team, no? So, I hope Rachel here would agree with me, no? So there was a clamor from our part kasi in the distribution of the social amelioration program funds, our BNS were not included, no? So we lobbied, no? We lobbied via text blast, etc., to the good secretary of DSWD. Ultimately, after that particular, nag-ingay talaga kami, the DSWD then issued Memorandum Circular 6, Rachel, if I am not wrong, no? So, Memorandum Circular 6 of the Department of Social Welfare and Development, which includes, among others, our barangay nutrition scholars in the availment of the Social Amelioration Program Fund, subject, however, still to the exclusion criteria. So, at least kahit may mga exclusion criteria, kasi hindi lang naman ang BNS ang may exclusion criteria, no? So lahat ng citizens of the countries kasali sa exclusion criteria. But nonetheless, yung hindi kasali sa exclusion criteria, we're able to avail of the SAP fund by the DSWD, received by our BNS. On top of that, there are aggressive local government units who really provides hazard pay with our BNS together with the other members of the BHERT and other members of the health sector, no, health workers. So sinali nila yon, no? So I can cite few examples, the like of the municipality of Balimasawa, the city of Maasin City, and probably the ones mentioned by Malu and Tess, no, kaya lang specific of municipality. And right now, even after ilan ba, March, April, May, June, magpa 5 months na tayo, we are still advocating our local chief executive to please naman provide support to our barangay nutrition scholars who are also at the forefront in the fight against COVID-19 in the respective areas of responsibility. Now, so those are the efforts we are, what they call this one, giving our barangay nutrition scholars. That's on top of capacitating them into some of the capability building activities of the National Nutrition Council and our partner agencies, even through virtual platforms na maisali sila. And they are still, no, the last time that we had our Executive Order 51 or the Milk Code, the Philippine Milk Code, you could just imagine around 250 to 300 BNS participated in spite the limitation of internet connectivity. No? So, ganun sila ka aggressive, which necessitate also each and everybody's support towards our warrior in the fight against malnutrition and COVID-19 in the barangay. Thank you again, Ms.
Thank
Olive.
Thank you for that. It would be good sana kung meron tayong statistics, Rachel, kung ilan ba yung barangay nutrition scholars natin dito sa Region 8 na nabigyan ng SAP. Meron ba tayo nun, Rachel?
Actually, we have another unit who are assigned to that. So I can give you later the contact number. You can get the data.
Mm-mm. Kasi the Philippine Information dated to give a daily pa nga eh, kaya kami ano nang ano kay Kila Joshua. Every day before 5 o'clock in the afternoon dapat meron kaming report tungkol sa SAP implementation.
Yes. Si na Joshua talaga Joshua, yung nakatoka.
Oh. So yun, kaya lang it would be good kung tayo dito sa Region 8 tayo yung mauna na makasubmit ng report kung ilan yung mga BNS na nabigyan ng SAP para medyo maiba-iba naman yung report natin. Okay?